Do you have the camera off again?
Recording.
Oh. See, when we go off video, you miss all the good stuff.
I didn't want them to hear me crunching this food.
Oh. Right, I'm going to regoop this gasket in here. Maybe it'll stop some of the leakage a little bit. Here's that gear in there. It's nice and clean now with all that rag material ripped through there. I'll just clean the oil off that gear.
That's it.
That's why I did that.
So it fits better.
One generator. Now you gotta make sure this goes over the gear. Just like that.
You lift it up and then shove it in and then it drops down a little bit.
This will take screws, get some old generator. I'll put Loctite on those. And you just rotate it back and forth until you find a spot where it's happy. Get that one started and go get the other one. Shove it all into the case. Okay. Use an impact knocker or I just do it with a screwdriver. Just do it with a screwdriver. Got the wrench over here?
Hmm? Yeah, I got it. I see it. That's a nice part about that.
See, it runs those screws off a little bit this way.
We need to get a new blade on the end of that.
I could get the impact knocker and beat the hell out of it.
That's
tight.
That's tight.
It doesn't matter anyway, this nut over here holds it down.
Which one is that?
The one you're not showing out of it.
Well.
Wrong side of the bike again.
And
it's hard to get you gotta stay away from the chips over there. See, it takes a special tapered washer here. Here, you gotta look at when you looked at it. You gotta figure out what the camera's at. Change out our socket to a half inch socket. All right, that goes through the hole first. There it goes. Taper goes up. It's universal application. And then you put the nut on the bottom.
Get your big knuckles out of the way so we can see.
Okay, let me do that.
I can see it.
Thank you. I don't see you pushing on that strap either.
Well, you want me to push on the strap?
Why do you think my thumb's going white?
Yeah.
Look at that, it's got a dent in my thumb now. Not that I was pushing on that at all.
Well, what kind of torque do you put on this?
Tight.
Okay.
Not more than that, more than that, more than that, and about that much. I'm gonna make
sure. He was just using a small wrench, so.
We want to make sure it's tight.
Limited.
I keep banging my head up here, too. So
limited torque, so.
All right, generator's in. Hope I did that right. Okay, we got the tranny bolted in. We got the motor in. Got the generator in. Next is carburetor.
Carburetor before heads? Yeah, probably.
It's easier to put it on now than later. So we got a carburetor. This is your plumber style.
Let me come around.
Okay, this has the one that just sits on top of the case. So you just kind of rotate it, bring it in, rotate it back, drop it down.
I'm kind of doing a good job. I'm trying to do a good job keeping up with all his movements, but.
Yeah, I move pretty quick. Okay, you get one of these tightened up first a little bit.
Slug it up.
You gotta make sure you got the flat spot on the other one so you can turn the nut on the other side. This one's not too bad because it's not the big nuts like on my KR. Got a lot less clearance in those. Okay, just bring those in lightly.
Okay.
With your fingers. And then you need a wrench. You didn't bring a wrench, did you?
Big wrench.
And a big wrench.
What he was saying is there's some that the bottom bracket actually mounts to the this side of the case. This one just sits on top of the case. Here he comes. The wrenches.
Big wrenches. So that's the one I use on my KR. See, that's why it's harder to get in there. See how much smaller that nut is? This looks like the genuine Harley wrench. This one here is another genuine, but see, it's a different angle. This should be the military one, though. Looks like it should be the right size. Look at that, it is. Slightly bring that one down. Bring that one down. Make sure the carburetor is sitting on top of the stand down there. It is. Okay, then you got to test tighten these up a little bit.
Squeaky.
Now, when you got this wrench on here, you got to make sure you have the wrench on the nut and not falling off the nut.
Right.
If you're right here and you pull on it, it's going to hurt your fingers when you hit the bottom of that case.
And you're going to bugger up that.
You also want to make sure you're not breaking fins off.
Yeah.
You can hold a wrench like this, which clears this, but it comes out and breaks it if you're not careful. And you have it this direction. Push. I usually just put it in here and push it until I hit the fins right here.
Right.
You have to look over here.
Oh.
Right up against the side of the motor there.
Yeah.
And make sure the wrench is all the way in, and make sure both sides are where I want to be. And then you push on it a little bit. I don't want to push on too hard, just a little bit.
You're standing on your toes.
The problem is, I have no leverage when I'm up here.
Because you're so light.
Yeah, because these are the bikes on the ground, I can put more leverages on it. Well, this one goes the other direction.
Right.
So right now, I can't get the wrench all the way in. So. Go like that. Now the bike's trying to fall off the rack, but that's okay. Yeah. A little torque on that one. Alright, I'll come up here. Put my wrench over. Torque. So that's torqued.
Carburetor's on.
So that's on there. And if the carburetor didn't move on you, that bracket should still be against the case down there.
And it looks to be down the case.
The carburetor still goes back and forth without any binding, which is a good thing. And it's not hitting here on the side of the fins anywhere, or over here. Because it was already came off this bike, so I know it's correct, but when it's the first time on, you got to double check, make sure the float bowl's not digging into the cylinder over here and all this other stuff. So that's how that goes on. Now when you got the heads on here, on aluminum heads, they overhang a little bit. It gets a little bit harder to get the manifold in and out. Cast iron heads usually don't stick out quite as far.
Okay.
Behind you over here.
Yep.
Over here, that's
the chip
bag. Yeah. Those are the heads? Look at the heads. Cast iron. 6-0s. And that doesn't mean 6-1 compression either. I don't know what the hell it means, but it don't mean no 6-1. This is from broken rings. This one's from rust. Uh-huh. It's got the same 6-0. It also got two lines on it. That means something to somebody. These aren't super low compression, but they're not high either. Now these, I had to open these up to half inch bolts. Put your hand.
And you do the same with the gaskets too, right?
These gaskets actually have enough on them. So these were already bolted down, that's why they're flattened out, but they only got 10 minutes of running time on them. So we'll go ahead and reseal them up, put them back on it. The bolts, I had to make up washers. I painted them too after I machined them. These are heat-treated washers, so they're really strong. These are non-heat-treated washers that are just thick. But you can see how they bend. See, we went to a little bit bigger size.
Mm.
But see, the OD is almost the same.
OD, outer diameter for those.
This is what the washer started out as, so you can see how a little bit different. So we had to make them this size so that they would fit inside the motor. So you had to fit down that little hole down there.
Right.
So we had to cut them all out. So that's why these are cut. For the bolts, the same thing, we had to go to a 12-point bolt. Same reason, so it fits down in the hole.
Right.
12 points have a small OD. You cannot put a hex bolt in there with a half-inch bolt. That'd be a 3/4 head, and there ain't no room for it.
Mm-hmm.
So I mean, see, I didn't put any extra on that. It's that size.
Good fit.
Yeah. I don't remember if I checked them yet to see if they all fit in there yet. Probably should double check just to make sure before I button them all up.
I would think that was a good start.
But anyway, that's how these are. And that's how much we actually got engagement of thread.
That's one of the things that impressed me. It was like everything was screwed to the bottom. And if the bottom wasn't deep enough, you'd make it deep enough. And a lot of...
Yeah. Where's my washers at? Comes here. This is my tool I use for doing this. So I had a bolt on here. I held out here in the center of the lathe. And I held this out here in the thread. And I had a nut on here. I tightened this all the way down. Hold on to those nuts when I was done. So these are fully torqued, and I machined them all the way across.
Oh,
sweet. It's also my paint jig. See how they're nice and stuck together? That's how you break paint apart. So. That way they won't rust quite as easy. Yeah, I was trying to get away. Yeah, trying to run away. All right, I gotta find a wrench for this. We can get a half inch, 7/16.
Half inch.
It is half inch. I guessed right too. Back on our quarter drive again too. Remember?
Yeah.
That one's not going down.
See, that's, yeah. This might be. I don't like that look.
It tightened the head up when I put that in there. See, when you don't make the bolts extra loose, they don't always line up again.
Right.
It may sound like that when they go in, see? Going a little snug.
That's going to happen on every one of them, I bet.
Probably.
And you're okay with that?
Well, I didn't say I was okay with it. I'm just saying that they're all the same.
They're all the same.
If we're lucky, they're all the same. See, this one goes up nice. We don't have to do this one. You don't think I'm going to drill every one of these out, do you? Then the head would flop all over the place. We don't want the head to flop all over the place. That's why I left them loose like this.
That was going to
be nice. That was a nice.
So there's two. I predict three. Nope.
Hmm. Yeah.
Yep.
That one's tight.
When the whole bike moves, it's tight.
Is that how you tell?
No.
All right, so we got this one for sure. Needs to be opened up. I'm thinking that one there, maybe too.
That one barely got.
This one will be okay.
You just scrape the paint off.
Yeah, I've got the paint off. This one here. Yeah, definitely very, very tight. This is the tightest one. Yeah, that one's definitely tight. Okay.
So, 1, 2, 3, 4.
There's only three. What do you mean four? But this one? That one there, isn't it?
Yes, that one.
That one's definitely tight. And this one here, I think, was falling down, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was going down, yeah.
That one's good.
That one's
really good.
Yeah.
I think that one's tight though, isn't it?
Yeah, you suspect it was.
So we've got three. That one's good. Okay, so we're gonna do three of them. So we're gonna open up those three holes and we'll open them up a 64th of an inch. Or a 32nd, depending on what my ringer is.
Okay.
I'm gonna check this other head.
Check the other one.
You know why I waited to do it now instead of later? Before? Because the motor's not moving around as much as if it was sitting on my little chicken shit little stand.
Go stand over here. I have a better view of these.
I should get two more bolts on there somewhere. Use the long bolts here. Better from this side over here. You just had to modify this bracket to make room.
Modify the bracket?
Well, we're putting a late model motor in this bike. This is a 37 later motor, and it's a 32 to 34 frame. You don't think all these parts fit together, did you?
Amazing. Some stuff they build, they never change, but yeah.
This is a intermediate year chassis with a late motor stuff in it. That's pretty bad. What late model means 37. And that's causing a lot of problems. The footboard assemblies are mixed too. The brake side over here is a 41 and later, and that one over there, the clutch side, is a 38 and earlier, 39 and earlier. Whatever year they change that. 40, they use that one to 40. You have all these fitment issues. Just like this is a 29 fork, 29 to 30 fork. That's another generation back. So always issues. See, we got to make headlight brackets for this one. We're going to take dual headlights. Unless you want to spend about $800 a headlight, you're not going to get original reproduction. Not even original repop lights.
$800 a piece for
You're going to pay either about $1,200 or better for lights. Not counting shipping taxes. Assuming you can even find them.
So are these going in all? That one's good.
This one's really nice. I like this one. This one here.
Close enough.
Yeah, it's just going in snug. That's all right. Snug's good. Yeah, it's all right. These ones all seem to be lines. That's pretty decent. The tight ones are tight, but not real tight. I can live with that. That one's loose. That one's tight, but it's working. That one's working. This one here is working. Okay, that one's all good. Just like this one's going in too, so it's just tight. See, we don't even have to do this one either. See, tight is a relative phrase. It's like having a lock nut on the bike. It doesn't fall out. And this one here is a little... Yeah, I gotta do something about that one. And this one here, yeah, these two we got to do something about.
So you're not going to do this,
Yeah, we could just hit it while we're in there with that.
Yeah.
It's tight.
Okay.
It goes in, though. It's going down.
Disassemble.
Yeah, we could live with this one if we had to. But these two here we got to work on. So that's only two for sure, maybe three we got to do. All right, so I'm going to pull all these all out, and we're going to go we'll go check them. So
all right.
You don't need to fill them.
Taking a break.
All right, these two are bad, and that one's only half bad.
Okay, what do you got?
Okay, I got an adjustable reamer here, half inch, and you just bump it up to whatever you want. So now I got it up here at about just under 220 or 520, depending on where you measure it at. A bit bigger than I thought. About 518, 517 right now. So it's about 518,000, so. That's basically a 64th of an inch, which is 516. So that allows this hole to be off by half of that. So that gives you 8 to 9 thou shift in the bolt. Should let us put it together. So go ahead and put this in the drill press and see what happens.
that drill press.
Not big. All right, if it doesn't rip out of our hand, we should be all right. If it does rip out of our hand, we'll have problems.
You don't want to break the head.
Dad or me.
Or your wrist.
It'll break the reamer off, I know that. The low speed on this isn't exactly low speed. At least half the speed, if not a third. Okay, those two we went a lot with. This other one's not quite as bad, so. There's a screw out here.
Just
take it out, it's easier. I think the thing actually slid up on us a little bit.
Went up, made it tighter.
Hard to believe it'd go tighter, but I never to be in it quite that far. Yeah, maybe it was.
Whoa.
You have to play back to camera to see that. Alright.
Tighter or looser? Even looser?
Looser makes it smaller.
Right.
We want to cut about 10 thou to 12 thou. Not quite as much. This is the one that I could probably run the way it was, but we're here. That was a brand new reamer.
It's like chalk going down a board.
It ain't new no more.
It's gonna make your ears.
That's how I treat my brand new tools around here.
Whatever it takes to get the job done, right?
That's about right. Look what it did to it. Killed it. Oh well.
Treat your toys better than that.
Nope. Beat the hell out of everything. Made correctly, we'll do that.
You just started working, man. I've been at this since.
I don't have to sit down on a job.
Four something.
Yeah.
I got up at 4:30.
I went to bed at 6:30. So what's the problem?
I got up at 4:30. You went to sleep.
That's right.
When I come here, you're like, let's get to work. I'm...
That's right.
Right. Okay. Let me start my second shift.
The sun was hot while I was sleeping.
One day.
You plan that right.
It was a warm day.
Not when I went up, it wasn't. It was already cool off when I got up. Okay, where's your other bolt at? Should be some long bolts in here somewhere.
Hmm?
I'm missing two bolts.
Don't even...
In here. Yeah, they're in here.
They're in there.
It's that one. That's that one there.
Yeah, two long ones.
Yeah, I'm looking for the other long one. That one there. It's hard to tell the difference when they're only a quarter inch different.
All right. Do this. Let me show these guys what I'm talking about. Put those bolts through the heads and hang them with them. Just a few of them.
What's that going
to
tell you?
I'm just showing the depth thing that you set this thing up to go to. That's some, like this, flat. Yeah, that's how far down they're going into the heads.
Except for this
one. Sure, you get good connection. Well, let's set a motor mount with it.
This one has to have this in there.
Quite often we run into these.
And another washer.
Yeah.
And I purposely, if you look at them, they got holes that go all the way down.
All the way down.
I purposely tapped them in there all the way.
I can actually see it. Yeah. So we run into people who are a lot of stripped out or walled out holes. When you pull the bolt out, it's only got going in a half inch.
Not even that.
Not even that in most cases. So that's one of the things that it takes the time to do.
So we have our assembly oil here.
Assembly oil.
We're going to assemble with it, so.
Didn't know that.
Otherwise known as a thread lubrication.
Now, why that over Loctite?
Because Loctite doesn't lubricate the thread as well as lubricant does.
No kidding, really?
And if you tighten the hell out of it, not that I would ever do that, of course, you don't need Loctite. Loctite's only when you can't torque the bolt enough to keep it tight.
There you go.
If you put stupid lock washers on there, when you tighten the bolt down, it just breaks the lock washer. So if you're not breaking your lock washers, you obviously are not tightening the bolts enough.
That'd be your non-.
Because I always break the lock washers when I torque bolts down. I don't know why, but.
Oh, lock washers, yeah. You don't use lock washers in most cases.
Very rarely. I do use them here and there, but sparingly. Usually there's a reason why I'm using it. One is I can't tighten the bolt down enough.
Yeah.
Two, there's a clearance issue. Still recording or flipping off on us again?
That's recording. That would be a text from...
Oh, that was you, not the camera?
Yeah. Oh. Hey, where are you? When are you coming home? Text.
No.
Let's see what it says.
That's why I don't have a cell phone. It makes it easier. Hard to believe, but I ran out of bolts. Okay, here's our head gasket holding fixture. Here's your head gaskets. This is paint you can't buy no more. No smudge aluminum. This is made to paint over those automatic transmissions that have a quarter inch of grease on top of an inch of dirt.
Oh, so they make them look brand new.
So it looks brand new. Which means it paints over everything. There it goes. So it's nice and thick. See how thick it is already?
Yeah.
This would be called sealer.
Sealer.
Now on the race bike, this is all we use. We don't use these stupid copper things here. We don't need these. Put a layer of this on there and tighten it down. It seals it. Regular dull aluminum, you'd have to probably let it sit for like two coats to get anything on there. All right, so now we take our washers and our bolts and we stick it up through the hole in the gasket and shove it up until it goes in the motor.
Get a better angle from over here.
Just get a couple of them in.
Get your elbow in the way.
I don't know who would do something like that. Take this one over here.
I was doing this one different. Attach the gasket first.
Well, it's dried. The other one was wet. This one had like a minute to dry already.
Dang, you're moving it.
That bolt's so tight, it didn't want to go in.
What are you doing?
There, go ahead.
What was that tight now? I guess I can help if I had a wrench though.
That's right.
About useless. There you go.
It'd be worthless. I got a socket we found out over there.
Real exciting stuff. Like watching grass grow.
Important. Put them all the way and just get them all started.
You can get all the way in.
You always want to get them all started before you start cramming them all in there.
Yep.
You have to get over here on the back. I can't reach.
All right, got it. Just give me a second. Get those started. Switch hands.
I did that one. Get these two started.
Well, it's a lot easier now.
Right.
Over there. What?
That fin looks really good.
I'm double tasking here.
5 minutes looking at one fin. Great.
Oh, come on. I'm getting my big ugly hand in the way.
That's right.
All right, that one's snug.
That's all right.
Somebody says anything about wobbly, it's like because I'm holding one hand and...
And the bike's moving back and forth too.
Wrenching. Not my fault.
Next thing is going to be an earthquake and then we'll have
not my
other
fault.
Stuff moving too.
I was in the garage with one hit. I'm sitting there looking up. I think I had a light, slight buzz anyhow, smoking a cigar. I'm like, man, that's a powerful cigar. Started like, man, everything's moving. That was a good buzz. Nope, it was an earthquake.
Same thing.
Yeah.
You have to get that one there. I can't get to that one either. How nice it looks. There's chrome hardware in here. When chrome, the customer's like, no, they don't like chrome.
Yeah. Okay.
It's hard to believe, but you can't buy black bolts in these lengths. You can only buy chrome ones.
Okay.
All right. Now we got next this step. Piece on.
And that would be the motor mount, top motor mount.
Okay, we're going to need a washer to go in here. Now, I purposely did not make a washer for this because I didn't think I would need one. I guess I spoke too soon. We have some other fitment issues too, as in it doesn't fit.
Okay, back over here.
Obviously it was made to go this way because this hole's been slotted out a little bit.
Yeah.
It actually lines up. When you flip the motor mount over this direction, it lines up nicely here, but look at the mismatch on that hole.
Oh yeah, it's way off.
So this motor mount has purposely been made to fit in this position here.
Get your finger out of the way.
I wanted my finger in the way. Now the problem is I only made two washers. I didn't make extra ones.
Extra ones for some height adjustment.
You got it. think I was going to have to.
Then you take a big freaking hammer to stuff.
Well, I thought I was going to be able to use a regular washer on that. But we might have an issue. We'll see.
A little bit.
We don't know yet. Yeah, it looks like it fits in there just fine. It's only hit on the one side. We can live with one side. We'll just go grind it.
Yep. Now, those were the original washers you started off with before you made the small washers, right?
Correct.
That's pretty wild.
The other problem is the motor mount.
It's got it all walking down.
It's a little bit, needs a little more cutting on it, too. So we need to put a flat spud on the one here. So we'll go flatten that off.
Yep.
And then we need to work on these holes here a little bit.
Yep.
So let's go play around with that.
Alrighty. Ooh, it's the old.
It's nice when you're right next
adjustment
to the working
tool.
Area. Figure out the grinder we want to use.
You know, he has a few grinders in his choose from.
That's a half inch on there. See, yep. That's how we know it doesn't fit. See? If it wasn't enough, this will fit in there. Some trimming out, let's see. Okay, I gotta get good. Go right here with your hands up. See how little that grinds, and I'm pushing it hard. Hard. Warmed up too.
It's hot.
All right. Look at that. Looks like we got a little bit better fitment now. It's hard to believe. Put that over there on that side. Well, that's a good sign. That one went in. Where's a quarter drive at?
I must have it on that side.
Of course. Why would you put it where I can get to it? I still dropped it. I was trying to save it. See, it slides the washer anyway. Doesn't matter. Okay.
What's this looking like?
Here. This one's not going to have an option of sliding. It's going to have to be cut down. Multiple locations. See, half that washer's in the way.
Yep.
Okay, how's our hole right here? Looks like our bolt will go through. Yep, we're good. Oops, we're going to have to come up with a little bit of washer for under here. And we're going to have to do some trimming for over here.
You wouldn't pull that down and just spread it out then?
Spread what out?
Just when you pull it down, it's going to...
No, I won't spread it down. It's going to put a hell of a bind on it. It's going to break. Turn this washer down on OD because it's just too stinking big. And this one here has the same problem. It kind of squeezes itself in, but really there isn't room for it. And the flat rotates on us when we tighten it because it overcomes the torque and it just bends the bolt out of the way. So what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to go ahead and trim the OD down on these to get them to work. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to lay that back in there for a minute.
All right, I'm going to take a break. He's actually using a torque wrench. Can you believe it?
Yeah, I didn't want you guys to think I didn't know how to use one. It's not that I really need one. I just torque the shit on them anyway. See, it doesn't fit in all the holes either.
Using the Tatro pattern?
You know, I use what I can get to. I can't get to the other ones. So much for this.
Now you got your tiny one. Multiple bending one.
Yeah, I don't think this will fit either because we got the height issue. What's this one set up? 50. I already did 50. That's just a starting point. These did pull torque real quick too. Unlike the other bolts that were in here that you couldn't even pull torque on most all of them. And the ones that did, you kept going in circles.
Yeah.
Not a sure sign that there was issues with the hardware. See, that one I can't get in there with. That one you gotta get to. Can't get to. Okay, we need to get a short bolt, 12 point.
Why didn't you bring that with you?
That's what I have. All right. Anyway, we're just talking, the camera shut off. Anyway, you're supposed to pull these 52 to 60 foot pounds. We're a good 60 at least. So we're going to go ahead and take these washers here, trim down the OD so they'll fit up in here, clear all this. I'm going to go ahead and cut these on down. And then we'll finish buttoning up these heads and continue on. All right, I'm gonna try a stupid tripod up there. Okay, I went ahead and turned these two washers down and threw some paint on them. So now these should fit right in here like we need to. This one here is the one that was the big problem. So now it fits. That one should fit good. Sure, it'll go in. All right. There's a little gap right here we got to fill down here between the motor mount and the frame. Just to be be about a 16th or so. So I'm going to go ahead and grab a washer and we'll come back and get that in there. Okay, here's our washer here. Just a little bit on the big side. A little bit too thick. So you have a little bit of rock right here. You can hear it a little bit. And as this motor grows up a little bit, it'll grow up and make it right, because the motor's going to grow with heat. Right now, this is going to pull it. These brackets are a little bit high. So when you put heat to it, it'll be okay. And the motor mount stick is flexible enough, it's not going to matter too much anyway. Let's see, that's not the right Loctite. This is the right one. So go ahead and put this thing in here for real. This is our spark plug cable clamp, bracket, whatever you want to call it. It's actually a clamp, but it goes underneath. Thick washer. And this. Now I got this going upside down because this bracket bends up right next to the head of the bolt under here. If I had it the other way around, it'd hang real low. So one of those situations where you have to put stuff on backwards for fitment issues. Even though it's not how you really want to do it. My tools over there. Okay. Down lightly. Let me bring down these down lightly. Things kind of center themselves up. Oop, wrong one. Where's my brake wrench at? There's my big one. Oop. Pull that down a little bit. Go ahead and pull these down. And then we torque it. 55 and a little extra. And then this one here, we're going to give a little extra torque. Okay, and we bend up our bracket here, and that'll hold our spark plug wire that comes across here, keeps it off of the motor. So that's how we do that. Actually, that one I might not like in that direction. But I might flip that upside down and put it on the top. I have to look at my wire, see how that looks. So. Put our spark plugs in here and take a look at that cable and see if I want to put this on the other side, maybe. Coil that. Not quite ready to put this in here yet, but we need to check the routing here, the wires. See what I think of it. Yeah, we'll be all right. The gas tank sits real low through here, so we don't want to get too high. So that should be sitting high enough to be over the fin here and here. The gas tank hangs down low, so I like that position. So I'll leave it right there. If I didn't like it, I would just flip it over somewhere else. We could flip this bolt over and do it 180 around, but it looks good. All right, so that's how that goes. I'll get my wrench to tighten these two plugs down, and that'll seal up our motor. So that's how you do all that. I gotta wipe these X's off too. So we'll move on to something else here.